For the second week of March and the second to last week of winter for 2019, I'm meteorologist Austen Onek with the News Channel 3 exclusive conservation, ecology, environmental blog we like to call Your Environment. Again, started this idea back about 20 years plus in Topeka, Kansas, to take a look at local recycling and conservation efforts, and it's continued on to the World Wide Web in video blog format to keep you updated with what's going on in various formats around the Mid-South area and with various events happening not only here but again throughout the continental United States and around the world. There's going to be one of those events coming up later on this week, the Youth Climate Strike, which is going to be again very interesting to hear about how that unfolds and gets covered in the news as the younger students of the world unite to tell a little bit more to the politicians and the leaders about how they feel about climate efforts so far to date and what they think needs to be fixed. So something to monitor there in the news as we go throughout the rest of the week, plus a little bit more about the rainforest. We'll talk more about that in detail in just a little while, plus what you can do to help out on things like that. Questions, concerns, ideas, anything that you would like to see on here, local recycling, cleanup events, things like that. Challenges to, again, pick up litter, increase recycling, anything like that, drop me a line at the email address here at austen.onek@wreg.com. Would love to hear from you and get that information out to the public. Now, normally we start off, again, with just a few bits of information about upcoming events. We're going to talk a little bit more about the rainforest coming up here. So we're going to start off with, again, our information about the clicks that we've gotten so far. You go to the rainforestsite.com. You click on the big green button, and that will again show you some advertisements, and that will again have the sponsors. Once you view those ads, the sponsors will pay to put aside and buy rainforest space so that it will not be developed. That's a very big issue and something that is very necessary for the health of our planet. Running total so far, thanks to over 3.6 million clicks so far for the first quarter of the year to date, 79 million square feet have been saved. That's over 1,800 acres, and that's decently good news, but unfortunately there's a lot of bad news to go along with that as well, as we take a look at again some of the reasons why that's going on in just a little bit. Again, coming up later on this week, the Youth Climate Strike is going to be a big issue, and it's being both blasted and lauded in various corners of the planet depending on political party and depending on age groups. It's again a very wildly divisive topic in its own way, but it is definitely not going away anytime soon. So if you'd like to follow more about this, we'll be talking more about that throughout the rest of the week, especially as we get closer to the event coming up as we go toward this Friday. So stay tuned for more on that. Air quality in the Mid-South looking very good at this time. That latest storm system that swept on through has done a very good job of clearing out the air, so we're not seeing much of anything out there in the way of major problems with pollution. We're looking at good conditions again out there with little of anything in the way of pollution to cause problems for anybody out there. Definitely not like the stagnant times of the year, mainly in summer and early fall, where we can get some pollutants and ozone gases built up as well. Deforestation in the rainforest, especially in the Brazilian Amazon, is again something that comes and goes depending on governments and their policies, and again how many people are trying to find land space in portions of the Amazon. Unfortunately, part of the lungs of our planet are being depleted by slash and burn techniques, cutting the trees down, burning them, and setting the area aside for forests, from forest space to farmland territory. And as you can see right now, we are seeing just a little bit more of a downturn in the last couple years. Unfortunately, with the new government in place in Brazil, it's a good possibility that that's going to continue that uptick that you see there over the course of the next couple of years. Places like the Rainforest Site, again, do a very good job of trying to make certain that everybody's aware as to what's going on. So again, clicking on the button and again viewing the ads that are on there will help to set aside that rainforest space, but it's a little bit too little, and we need more people to participate in stuff like this, because unfortunately at this time over 1.5 acres of rainforest are developed and lost every second, and we are losing even more throughout the course of even just a day. Amazing amounts of this are going on, and the Amazon deforestation is up from last year, and that was in 2016. And that trend upwards is expected to continue. Unfortunately, again, we're also adding to the problem out there with the burning of the trees and the foliage in the rainforest that is designed to clean the air. We are adding to the problem by burning everything in the area there, and that's helping to increase the possibility of climate change out there by adding to the smoke and the carbon that gets into the atmosphere. So again, the difference is absolutely striking when you take a look at what has happened. A once vibrant rainforest has again been pretty well torn apart and barely anything is left, increasing runoff from rainfall, increasing the possibility of erosion, destroying eco environments down that direction. A lot of that is due to what the governments in that area call illegal logging, but a lot of it is the governments that turn kind of a blind eye to what goes on there, or promoted by the government so people can find land and farm space in there. But it is a very widespread problem and increasing as, again, the amount of rainforest space decreases and we start to see, again, less and less that can clean the planet and help our air stay cleaner, which is not good news for everybody on the planet. And a lot of places have done a good job of keeping track of what has gone on down there. You can examine these websites to take a look at what goes on, and the crops that are grown there to be sold for profit are part of the problem. And if you decide to, again, fight back against what is going on down there, it's an easy way to do so. Even though you're thousands of miles away, the smoke from those fires is something that you are breathing in, but there are suggestions about what you can do out there. The World Wildlife Fund is a good place to start. Natural Resources Defense Council, all those places have, again, suggestions about what you can do, the products you can buy that are marked rainforest safe, the research that you can do. These are good places to learn a little bit more about what goes on there. You can also see, again, thanks in part to all that smoke, you can easily track that on places like earth.nullschool.net as we see, again, the carbon dioxide increasing from the area of the rainforests and in places where slash and burn farming has been on the increase. Very telltale signs going on there and something that you can take a look at yourself on your computer system out there as those farms continue to produce different crops. And again, if it's safe to grow in the rainforest, they should be marked properly, and there's better ways, again, of doing things than what we are doing to our rainforest space out there. Other groups that might be able to help you understand more, the Chickasaw Group of the Sierra Club, including their events coming up, including how you can learn how to speak to legislators about things like climate change and pollution, and making certain that our legislators know a little bit more about how we, the voters, and the electorate feel about what goes on there. Wolf River Conservancy, cleaning up the Wolf River Channel and doing a lot to, again, introduce the concept of conservation and ecology to younger group members with things like World Water Day, the Wolf River Harbor Cleanup, local bonfires that, again, can bring people together in celebration of nature. It's a good opportunity to learn more, and you can find out more at wolfriver.org to take a look at more about what's going on out there. There's local groups, there's international groups, there's groups all over the place that can help you understand more about how we live on this planet and what we can do to, again, bring more stable environment to the planet to help out on things. So there's not nothing that can be done. There's a lot that can be done, and you can help out on stuff like that. So please remember that. Coming up in about 20 days, it's time for Earth Hour once again, and we're going to be participating in that for, I believe, the fifth year in a row. If you'd like to see more about our energy usage here at News Channel 3 and what we leave on when it comes to lights around the building and how and why we should be able to turn those off and use less energy and better energy practices, that's coming up in just about 3 weeks. We'll talk more about that over the next couple of weeks. And again, we'll have a special presentation on this in about 3 weeks. So definitely want to stick around for more about what's coming up on Earth Hour. And again, across the area on a lot more going on. More information on that, you can go to earthhour.org to find out more details about what you can do, how you can participate, and if any local groups are going to be participating in that as well. So again, find out for more on that. Again, questions, concerns, anything you'd like to know about our blog, or if there's anything on here you'd like us to promote and tell people about in the Mid-South area, Memphis Metro, places like that, please let me know. Again, austin.onek@wreg.com. Would love to have you along for that. And of course, we'll be tallying more information as we go over the next several days and weeks about other things that will be coming up that you can help out with, again, both locally or globally, it's all, again, a good opportunity for you to get involved and to help make certain that your planet is a better place to live. Again, more coming up next week on our next edition. But again, thanks for joining us for the second week of March. From downtown Memphis and the News Channel 3 WREG studios, I'm meteorologist Austen Onek. Thanks for joining us for this week's edition of Your Environment.